900 cavalos, cara. É forte, hein?
Ele deu uma.
Hey guys, we're here today to show you some details about a very unique car we have today on the dyno. This is probably one of the very few four-cylinder big block Volkswagen we can call. This is like a custom-made, almost one-off big block Volkswagen air-cooled engine. So this is a boxer four-cylinder. This engine was designed by the owner actually, almost as a project. He'd been challenging over the years to develop. This is a fully billet engine, billet block, billet heads. It uses a lot of the V8 parts, including pistons, rods, bearings, valve train. So it's a big of a challenge to how to develop an engine so unique like this. This engine is 3.5 liters and uses a compound turbo system, which is like the small turbo from the system is a 88 millimeter turbo from Precision Turbo, and the big turbo is a 106 millimeter turbo. So it's a definitely interesting project. It was, nobody knows the limits on this engine, so they are here to pretty much figure how much power this engine can make, how much it will handle, even the RPM range. Right now they are revving the engine at 8500 RPM, which seems to be very safe and very easy for the project. This car already runs 670 on the racetrack. It's kind of a heavy car for the class. And on the racetrack, I believe it ran about with 90 or 100 pounds of boost, but it wasn't really on the best tune. So that's why they brought the car up here, so they could find the better tuning on the car, or find or even test some, especially in the compound turbo, they could test better a balance between both turbos, because on a compound turbo, it's really a challenge how to split the effort of each turbo to make sure the turbos are actually in the best optimal performance on the compressor efficiency graph. So we're happy to have these unique projects with us. They're using also a lot of FuelTech products. They're using the FTSPARK 1500 millijoules, which is in this case when the testing they're running right now, running under 0.50 lambda, which is like two below 3 AFR methanol. It's performing very, very nice. The car also runs 8 injectors of FT injector, 720 pounds per hour injector, and it is very interesting, very nice how precise the injectors are controlling the engine, how everything is running so smooth. The EGTs are showing very, very similar, even with a very small correction, so it's cool to see that the engine itself is very balanced, but also everything else like the injectors are very precise. This car also runs the ECU is a FT600 that controls everything. It does have the wideband Nano from FuelTech, so you can read down to 0.35 lambda, and we did a few passes on that low before really finding the numbers on this car. So it's amazing how wide range you can go even on the Bosch 2 sensor with the wideband Nano. This car uses TurboSmart wastegates with CO2. Definitely we're seeing that these wastegates needs to add more flow because they are wide open to try to control the exhaust flow from this engine. So this is one of the upgrades they will do. We think they will probably going for the electronic wastegates on the new straight gauge 50 millimeters, which it flows a lot more than the old style 60 millimeters. So that's another upgrade we know they are going to do in very few. This car has a lot of data log also incorporated to the FuelTech. So they have turbo speed for each turbo. They have back pressure before each turbo as well. They have the intermediate boost reading between turbos, sure, the map sensor. Then they have fuel pressure sensor or oil pressure sensor, the EGTs through EGT4. They also have like a drive shaft RPM sensor, input shaft RPM, which is very important for the slipper clutch. This car uses a Easy Motorsports slipper clutch, which is very popular on the import. This car was built by Titan Motorsports. Eric Luzinski is the tuner, and they've been doing a great job on a completely new platform. Everyone knows Titan Motorsports as a 2JZ builder and very successful on that. So it's cool to see them playing in another platform and doing so well. I hope you guys enjoy this completely different car, this different project. We hope they see a low 6 seconds after this dyno session and after these new upgrades. Thanks everyone for watching.
Days at the dyno trying to help the developer of this amazing engine, Pety Fuser engines, made in Brazil, developed in Brazil. Small four-cylinder, let me say, because the four-cylinder is not that small. Full billet boxer combination, just like a Beetle. But there is no Beetle power here. By the third day, playing with boost, playing with this RPM fueling timing, we were able to reach over 2,000 horses at the hub. So we never even heard about such power. And honestly, if we take in consideration what it should be making at the crankshaft, this is the most powerful four-cylinder ever measured on any kind of dyno, right? That's crazy. So I'm here with the master, the creator of this beast, and we're gonna talk a little bit in Portuguese since he's from Brazil. I'm gonna try to do a live translation for you guys. Pet, que tu achou disso tudo? Assim, a gente vem aqui, a gente, o motor se comportou bem para dedéu, né? Tudo funcionou e veio as potências. E a impressão que parece que tá tipo, pé nas costas, né? Sim, tipo, estamos caminhando ainda.
Foi incrível, né? Eu acho que foi bem proveitoso esse teste que nós fizemos aqui. Deu pra gente entender bastante o funcionamento dos dois turbos, né? O motor está se comportando muito bem, né? O gerenciamento do motor também pela FuelTech nos trouxe muita novidade, né? Mostrou bastante pra gente como tudo está funcionando. E assim, estou bastante contente, né, com os resultados. E o mais importante é que a gente sabe, né, e já percebeu que dá para extrair mais power, mais potência do motor.
Hey, you guys gonna check the subtitles, like, it's really cool. I'm not going to do a real-time translation for you guys, but like, what we just spoke back and forth, like, it seems there's so much more. Like, it looks that it made 2,000. We ran over 100 pounds of boost, about 110 on this lap. And the motor seems to be behaving the same when we ran low boost, like 50 pounds to 110. And we're like, okay, it's fine. There's no, you know, severe heat on the plug. Oil pressure is awesome. You know, valve trains work. Everything is working. So like, it's just, it's impressive machine. Like, we don't know what is the limit at. So I believe now it's like back to analyze how the motor behave, you know, take it apart, try to understand and see what we need to make to come back here or the track. And see how fast can you go, how much power can you make. So Pety right here, he already holds two records.
Yeah.
He is the quickest boxer with the rear mount engine back in Brazil.
Yes.
7.4 you said?
Yeah.
7.4 to the quarter mile. 200 miles an hour. And this one already hit the track before coming here. They start actually at the track to try to figure out the car as well. And they already went 6.7 and a quarter mile without this power. So the whole goal is achieve the 5 seconds, be able to fight for the record with quick guys like Carlos Daud and Carl Brunet, the actual record holder, the only 4-cylinder that been to the 5 seconds.
Yes.
Então tu vai tentar, né?
Sim.
Vai tentar por 5 segundos.
Sim, vamos tentar. Eu tenho certeza que a gente vai atingir esse número aí.
So, thank you guys for watching. I hope you guys had a lot of fun watching this marvelous machine over here. I personally had like a lot of fun. I was driving the thing, I was helping, trying to tune it here and there. We were discussing back and forth what to do with the motor, like the whole group of guys working together to try to understand this motor. And now, back to Florida, right? With your buddies from Titan.
Yeah.
Eric Luzinski on the clutch. And
let's
send down the strip and see how fast this car can go. Man, congratulations.
Thank you.
Amazing machine you built.
Thanks.
See you guys next time.